42.
42.
61.
What class are you from?
41.
41, all right.
Give me one.
Get a little wave there. Give a little wave. Okay. Who's this? What class do we have here?
56.
56. Excellent.
57.
Oh,
I don't know.
Hey! Far Rockaway, another 100 years.
Yeah, all right. Right.
That's what my aunt says.
Hello.
Tonight I got something going on at our temple, but I'm gonna come over. I'm gonna come over late.
That's good. What you have your earmarks?
No,
there?
I'm not
I just
saying
who's fortune having my mouth.
Rep, come with me. Hey everybody.
Hey.
We're on video.
You sound good.
Wait, I know I gotta do this, right?
As I'm picking my
What do we got here?
Something wonderful.
Gonna make it live action video here.
Live action.
What classes do we have here?
1974.
65.
69.
What classes do we have here?
Rockaway Matriots.
They're right there. What do we got here? Let's see.
Watch it.
All right.
Well,
I don't know if we're going to see much of that because of the sun coming through it. What classes do we have here?
1940.
1940, all right.
65.
1940. What do we got? What do we got?
61.
61.
66. 61. Rich Fleisch now.
That's what I said. No,
what classes do we have here?
Wow.
65.
From Del Mar, California.
So what classes do we have?
63.
He can't hear you.
63.
62.
60.
62.
70.
I haven't graduated yet.
Oh, okay. You keep working on it.
Class of 55.
55.
Class of 66.
I
football, baseball, stupid.
Cheerleader 68.
64. 68.
Jack Kirschman, where are you?
66, great.
63.
Jack Kirschman,
1968. 69, there are more of us here than any other class. Great class of 80.
What year do we have here? What classes we got?
39.
1930, all right. 1930. Any good words for us?
Well, I played on the football team, the first team that played in this school.
Is that right?
That's right.
Well, you got to cheer them on real good this year.
Okay.
57.
What years we got here? What class we got? What do we got here?
71.
75.
75.
72. 63.
76.
Oh, got a cheerleader.
Rah, rah.
Go ahead, turn around. Let's see the back of that.
She's got her jacket.
Doesn't shut, but it's open.
You know, I kept my major record.
What do we got here? What year we got here?
1961.
61.
61 and in great shape.
75.
Need help or anything?
No, we're doing good. What year are you from? What year we got here?
1962.
This is
going to
be
the
biggest.
Oh,
yeah. Hey, this is Sarah. Oh. It's going to be on the video.
Absolutely the best place to throw it.
Hey, you got me before you got me again. I'll be here forever.
Right, girl. Yes, it is.
to help these things.
Cheers tonight. And some orchards if anybody wants them. They're really inexpensive.
Ready?
Hey, Far Rockaway!
Hey, camera! Alumni boosters! Tell me what you want, and I'll get you what you want.
Ready?
Okay. Hey! Get everybody. We got the 40s here, eh?
Get up on the top.
This is part of the committee. Hope everybody has a good time.
We'll do them
thank
too.
You. What's this
we got
for?
The 40s here.
All right.
We're 50.
And the 50s.
40s.
50.
I can't 50. Hear you.
50 all the way from San Diego, California.
Florida.
Tusker.
San Diego.
Where
are
you from?
New Jersey. Mount Holly.
Hey.
Arizona. Phoenix, Arizona.
You're doing the video for the whole production.
You're looking at me? San Diego, California.
6 o'clock news.
Wait. Shelter Island, New York.
Hurry up, this is a good hug.
Yay!
35 years.
I know, your wife's gonna see this, don't you?
I don't care if my wife sees it.
Okay, what do we got here? What do we got here? You can go back, you can go back. Go ahead, go ahead. Yeah.
Harvey Samuels played the trumpet, still does.
1953, pretty good year. Neil Hyland, all city champ. What year?
63.
Oh, there! Jonah Trebos, a class of 1968. All right.
wife first! Yeah, I had his wife first!
Rockaway! Rockaway! 62! You're 52! What a great high school! What a great place to grow up! A unique place! Only we can do something like this! Doesn't exist today at all!
I'm gonna wait till I sit down and then figure out what I'm gonna do.
Let the camera go.
Hey, I know you!
You can make it now.
I feel like I'm in high school again. Don't bluff the aisle.
Go!
R-O-C-K-A-W-A-Y, Rockaway, Rockaway.
Yeah, Rockaway.
What year we got here? What year?
78.
78?
80. 80.
All right.
Go Rock.
Let's get Far Rockaway!
Yay!
What do we got here? What do we got, the 40s?
40!
I can't hear you!
40!
Who is that guy?
The sign down here.
Who we got? Oh, there's the sign. To your left.
Here we go!
There's the sign. There
we
I could
go.
You miss it.
Hi, here I am again.
Come on up, Ralph. Try to get everybody in a nice pan.
What channel?
40s!
Come on up a little more. Come this way.
Still got a sweater when it's off.
What do we got here, 40s? Come on, guys!
CNN? How about the BBC?
Hey, guys!
Hey! Into that camera!
Help! Hey!
Who's gonna win today?
All right.
Hi. Hi there.
How are they making it?
See ya. Great day. Great day.
No, well, because I edited it and I put it all together nice.
Beautiful.
You'll have it if you order it tonight.
I'd like that. Thank you very much.
100 years.
Say cheese. Say cheese.
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 Coach for another 40 years.
Yeah. Football coach?
No,
basketball.
Basketball. Baseball and basketball, yes.
You know what?
Well, what did you say before?
They're the oldest group.
The oldest group graduated from Far Rockaway High?
That's right.
What year are we talking here?
What year, Sydney?
1930.
Excellent.
No, I'm 39.
38. Wait, hear it. What else we got here?
38.
That's it. 38
over there. 38.
What year we have there?
38.
38?
38.
You guys need to school?
Hey, how are you doing?
Lewis Rosenthal, class of 36.
That's who made me a manager. I was a state manager.
All right, here we go. Class of 37.
37?
Yes. They're hardly, not too many of them are still alive.
You missed the school, right?
I missed the school like hell I do. Keep going.
We got you. We'll be back. We're going to do more.
Would you come to Greensboro, North Carolina? That's where I'm from.
North Carolina?
Greensboro.
Greensboro. Big town.
Beautiful.
Worth the trip so far, isn't it?
It's wonderful.
You meet a lot of your school chums?
Not a lot, just a few, and I'm delighted.
That's great. Good. We hope you have a great time.
Thank you so much.
Yeah! What year we got?
67.
67.
Yes. 1967. Yay for Rockaway.
To your left. Thank you. What year we got?
I'm teaching.
Existing teacher? What year we got? What year we got?
60.
1960.
60. Yeah, really,
60.
65.
65.
Yeah, that's right.
78.
Okay, that's good.
Responsibility. You.
Hello. Put it on the little girl. She's cute.
Here we are.
Oh, hi.
Class of 60. 1960.
Yes.
We're the ones. Hey, guys. What year we have here?
1958.
59. We're on video.
This gentleman is a classmate of Ed Barry. Right?
And we're from 38. Class of 38.
Wow.
She just carries my bag.
Okay. What year we got here?
1969.
69. All right.
We're
58.
How about a teacher? 68 to
70. There we go, a teacher. They'll all want to see you.
Hello.
Okay, let's go to stand.
Why am I like my
What year are you from?
1983.
1983.
My English teacher?
You're English?
Reuniting students and teachers.
Are you still in school?
No, I'm at the high school superintendent's office.
Aha.
1980, Rockaway Major X. This is exciting. Where are you guys? Jean, Joyce, where are you? How you doing? Love you guys. Class of 80, remember the class of class. Take care.
Class of 71. Very proud graduates. Went on to college in Arizona.
My sister.
And I'm very happy to be here. This is my sister, 1980, cheerleader and all that good stuff.
Tony Castro, Robert Castro, Christina Robinson.
Yes. Hey guys, what year we got here? What's
1968! Original shakers, 1974 cheerleaders. Yeah!
that voice.
78 was better.
They're scared of her.
Absolutely. She was great, though. And I'm 1973.
I live in Florida now.
I'm here. Yeah, I do the same thing. I have the X2D.
Happened to our motto battle.
Very long.
Are you?
I remember that.
We're doing it for the school. And we're going to have them. You'll be able to order copies of this. Oh, nice.
Yes.
But at least I represent.
72, there we go.
But at least I represent.
What year are we from?
67.
23. Nice to be here. And
take these guys.
Just look for us.
This is for the video that they sell.
Stan Cohen.
Sheldon. Tell them the years. Yeah. Give them the years.
63. Skip Weinstock, Arnie Schwartz, 63.
Barry Stein.
Barry Stein, I remember.
Barry Stein. He's finally come back. Oh, I knew Canada.
I'll put it by his jacket on the stairs.
Where's his jacket? No, you might want to do it to the stairs. So it could be a good shot, too.
You can't go on the field, though.
Not yet, no. As soon as they have part of
the ball. With the older generation, what do you keep taking the younger ones?
Give me a few minutes to think of an answer to that, okay?
What?
Jack, they want to say hello to you on camera. This is Coach Jack Hirschman, who's been to Far Rock from 1951 through the mid-80s. Coach Emeritus of the football
coach. Team. How are these guys doing out there today?
Very well.
They
very
are.
Well.
You're proud of them?
Look out. Here comes the ball. Whoa.
Lisa!
That was almost a ball.
That's right. We almost had Kirschman back on the field.
Lisa.
Yeah, really.
Any questions? No questions. So,
no, because I'm not really
35 years of my life
Lisa.
Devoted to a beautiful school, beautiful people, and they were just... We just had one marvelous time.
That's great.
Yeah. Okay.
What am I going? How are you?
Done. You already got it. Go Far Rock. Let's go Far Rock.
Cheerleaders and the majorettes of the decades from the 40s on up. So
Quiet.
Another person who has left us. Lance Harrison left the Flores. And a very close and dear friend, Peter Andriakis. You may know him, you may not have, you may, might have played him. And I've spent 35 years of my life here on this field. It's been a beautiful feeling that all of you came this day on the 100th anniversary and you all got together. I see you embracing and hugging. It's fantastic, and you should all be congratulated. Yay! We were going to go through by decades of the groups that played here, but we are short of time. The teams have to come out. Far Rockaway has to win. Yeah. So please stand, all the athletes who have played here, and God bless you all. See you tonight.
Thank you.
lot of people who are waving to the camera. Maybe we'll be good at
what
we want.
Yeah.
I'm having a great time.
Can't videotape the class from Landy, man.
Nice.
Thank you.
pleasure and an honor to introduce the lady who really brought all of this together. She's not only our chairperson of the Centennial Celebration Committee, but she inspires us, she makes us laugh, she makes us cry. Ladies and gentlemen, from the class of 1962, Barbara Foxton Harriet.
Something perhaps a little bigger, certainly a little better than just the 3 years. Ladies and gentlemen, this is it. It doesn't get better than this. I would like to introduce each one by one. The people that are responsible for not only the weekend, but the information that you got so wonderfully and the information you will continue to get. The Alumni Association is alive, it's well, it's kicking. We're going to support it. And just keep remembering where you came from. We still have sand in our shoes. Not in any special order, because everybody worked diligently in what they were doing. I'd like to introduce you to the committee for the 100th Centennial Celebration. I guess I should just take the order of this thing, and it'll be easier. Elaine Lichtenstrahl, who is the Secretary of the Alumni Association, and Elaine worked tirelessly, taking notes, making phone calls, and just getting the job done. Thank you, Elaine. Gail Ross, who started and helped with the insurmountable task of getting a database so that we could get the message out to every one of you. Gail. Sharon Gabriel, who did a phenomenal job with the motorcade this morning, with the beach club last night, and just kept everything together. Sharon. Fran said, Fran is keeping everybody very hospitable in the hospitality suite, and she's responsible for the early registration this afternoon for anybody that's staying in the Marriott. Please come to the hospitality suite between 4 and 6 o'clock and pre-register so that you're not standing on the lines. Fran. Larry Schiffer, who worked on our database and worked on the internet outside. Lots of people didn't see him, but you have certainly seen his handiwork. Larry Schiffer. My point man, my list man, my list of numbers, who doesn't go any place without his laptop computer and our phone number, Rob Schnitzer. Okay, chairman of this afternoon's lunch and the brunch tomorrow morning, actually both chairs, Linda Lambert and our very wonderful president of our Alumni Association, Warren Kramer. The lady who has a thankless job because whatever can, will, whatever did, didn't, but she kept it all together between the high school, the telephones, and us, Barbara Saber. Our other hospitality gentleman, who's working with Fran and has worked endlessly stuffing envelopes and being head of the mail committee, along with Bob and Rhoda Rosenman, who are not here this afternoon, Ira Goldfein. The lady responsible for our afternoon halftime performance, a teacher who has worked tremendously long, schlepping from the city every time we asked her and doing everything that we asked her of her, Rosalie Beal. I don't see him, I'm sure he's probably outside driving the bus. Our Director of Transportation, Larry Rubenstein. With the number of people that we have, we can't do anything without knowing that everybody is safe. Our Director of Security, Norman Rapport. And a young lady that I have to tell you must be an exceptionally good friend and is doing this for a labor of love because she did not go to Far Rockaway High School and has done, no, it's okay, we will take people who didn't go as long as they worked as hard as this young lady did, our chairman of souvenirs, Andrea Relkin. Very briefly, and we're going to be very brief, there are a couple of people that we need to introduce because there have been some very important proclamations given to our high school in honor of what we're doing. I'd like to call on our assemblywoman. I don't want to get this wrong, Audrey. Not only is Audrey our assemblywoman, she's also a graduate of Far Rockaway High School. Please welcome Audrey Fagan Pfeffer. Thank you, and this is the class of 1959. We're really glad to be here. But I'm really very excited and want to thank everyone. There's a lot of us here in this auditorium and in this surrounding area that never left. And we've been fighting all along to keep this community together, and we're just happy that everyone did come back. I'm the Assemblywoman. This is still my area. I still live on Mott Avenue, and I was elected every 2 years to represent this community. We love it, and what we do at Albany is that this time, this wonderful time, and everything that's happened in the 100 years of Far Rockaway High School, it's part of permanent records, as we call it, but it's all part. We have a resolution that's passed in the New York State Assembly. We have a wonderful resolution from Governor Pataki, one from Mayor Koch, and we even have our letter. As you go back, after 1960, the lines are going, so we apologize. And also from the Board of Education itself, from the Chancellor now, who happens to be Rudy Cruz. So everyone through the years took time to remember Far Rockaway, and we're certainly glad, I'm certainly glad, that you've come home and are going to share this wonderful weekend with all of us. Just to address you briefly, another former graduate of Far Rockaway High School, Assemblyman Dan Feldman.
So Far Rockaway High School has two members of the New York State Legislature. On the other one, I was not a majorette, but I want to say this. We all, certainly those of you from 66 know what a great school it was then. Jimmy Richardson, the principal, showed me how to be principal for a day last spring. And I have to tell you, it's a great school now. But with what we're generating, but with your generating today, it's going to be better and better and better. And I personally, for all the thrills I've had, yet last night and today, and this wonderful thing, I want to again thank Barbara Zakaria and all our team for this miracle they produced. And thank you all, this is great.
We are the product of a wonderful place, a wonderful school, a wonderful institution. I don't know how many of you are aware of this, but except for Bronx High School of Science, which is supposed to turn out those kinds of people, Far Rockaway High School has produced more Nobel Prize winners than any other school in the country. Among the people that have helped us to do that, I would like to introduce some former teachers that are here. They're just going to stand up, they'll wait, and then if you'd like, you can see them outside. Lydia Kaufman, who was an English teacher from 1960 to 1963. Mrs. Riley, who was with the school 42 years from 1929 to 1970, first as a math teacher, and then, believe it or not, Far Rockaway had a total accounting program, and Mrs. Riley was good enough to teach some of those students cost accounting and auditing. Mrs. Riley. Now out on the field, you got a chance to meet Jack Hirschman and some of the Jack has been a physical education teacher with Far Rockaway for 35 years. Thank you. And even as well as a teacher for many years, and I know he's looking forward to seeing all of you who remember him. Thank you, Mr. Barry. Experiences and certainly a teacher who made a tremendous impact on me and my life, and I talk about him to this day. Ladies and gentlemen, a very, very warm welcome for Earl Jabez.
With you, I watched him hold Congress and the nation spellbound with his O-ring demonstration after the Challenger disaster. Dr. Feynman died in 1989, and there's sort of a cult that's developed a little bit around him. And we at Far Rockaway are immensely proud of him, his accomplishments, and his legacy. Just this week, for example, he was referred to in an article in the New York Times as the most loved and popular American scientist of all times. And I think that for those people who got to know him, you'd understand that his unbelievable ability to reduce what was really frightening complex to the understandable for the average among us, which made him really the great teacher and scientist that he was. I don't know about you, but I'm just awed that Dr. Feynman started his career right here at Far Rockaway High School. But what's even more amazing, as Barbara's mentioned to us, is that Richard Feynman is just one of three Nobel Prize winners, prize-winning students from here at Far Rockaway. Bernard Blumberg, a geneticist, won the award in medicine, and Bert Richter, another physicist, won it in 1976 for his discovery of the cyclins. And he later became the director of the Stanford Linear Accelerator, which is perhaps one of the most renowned scientific facilities in the world. And as Barbara mentioned, with three Nobel Prize winners, Far Rockaway ranks second to the Bronx High School of Science. And we know just nerds know the Bronx Science anyway. As having the most Nobel Prize winners in the world. I want to put this in just a little bit of context for you. I live in a suburban school district in Pennsylvania, in Philadelphia, which prides itself and is recognized as being the foremost science school district, having the number one science high school in Pennsylvania. And it constantly continues to point out to the students and parents that our school in Philadelphia graduated A, Nobel Prize winner. Far Rockaway graduated first. And it's what's unbelievable still to me is that Dr. Feynman, the most brilliant physicist of his generation, attended assemblies in this very auditorium, learned science and math in this building, from teachers who taught, in some cases us, and sometimes our parents, and participated in the same kinds of clubs and after-school activities almost all of us, we participated in. We can, I think, just recall the excitement of learning that went on within these walls for so many years. And I think that's evident in the response that the faculty has had today from everyone in this room. When Earl Jagus walked onto that football field today, the glow and the love in this crowd, this group, was indescribable if you didn't go to Far Rockaway. I was very flattered that Richard Feynman visited us. And preparing for today, I wanted to ask myself, what was it about him that would cause this man, at the very height of his career, and having just recently won science's highest honor, to want to come back to visit the school? And what I've come to conclude is that in many ways, Richard Feynman came here for the very same reasons we've come back today. He, as one of us, grew up in this special place. Far Rockaway was special in that it had, on one hand, New York's big city sophistication, and what was really the greatest public school system for 30 or 40 years, and on the other hand, a small town atmosphere, highlighted by a beach and boardwalk, by main streets of Beach 116th Street and Central Avenue, and most of all, Far Rockaway High School. I dare say that this blend of experiences is what's brought us back today to share these memories with our classmates, former teachers, and friends. Since most of us have graduated, of course, the world has very much changed. And one of the most unfortunate changes has been in the Board of Education's inability to offer today's students what so many of us benefited from us when we took for school, but when we were in school. Far Rockaway science and math courses, classes, many of which you attended and it's close, produced 3 Nobel Prize winners. Here at Far Rockaway, student government produced political leaders, such as Dan Feldman, my classmate, who's going to be the, has been in the state assembly serving with distinction for 17 years and will be the next U.S. congressman for this district. Dramas and glee clubs produced television and film producers, directors, including another classmate of mine, Roy Bittan of the E Street Band. And then, of course, there's always the class of 96, Revenge on the World, Richard Betty. The cat and the dolphin created future journalists like Richard Cohn, who today still continues to write about Far Rockaway in his articles in the Washington Post. All I want to stress to you is that so many of the values that we picked up because of what Far Rockaway was able to offer to us, but which it unfortunately can't offer future actors, writers, and musicians the same opportunities. And it's this void that the Alumni Association wants to fill. And through its fundraising effort, would like very much to raise $100,000 to be able to fund programs that today's students need and can't get. There's already been $12,000 worth of computer equipment donated through Rob Schnitzer and the Bankers Trust Company. That's a small start. That's only a start. But I've got phenomenal news to say that we've actually can come within half our goal. Carl Icahn, a member of the class of 1953, who unfortunately can't be here today, has made a remarkably generous gift to Far Rockaway by making a $50,000 pledge, a challenge to all. Far will match dollar for dollar every dollar that the Alumni Association raises for us. And what we'd like very much to do is for each person here and each person attending tonight to actually buy the seat you're sitting in right now. For $100 and a tax-free contribution to the school, the Alumni Association will put your name on a plaque, just like this, and attach it to a seat. We need very much to do this, and we'd like to do it. It's the experiences that we share that enabled us to do what we've done, all of us. I know that I personally thank Far Rockaway High School for what little I've been able to contribute. And if there isn't a Nobel Prize winner in physics here in Far Rockaway today, maybe there is one in art, or science, or literature, and maybe peace. But without the kind of support that we receive, these students won't have the same chance. And I'm asking you to make a tangible commitment to show how we made Far Rockaway and will continue to keep it a very special place. I thank you so much. For